All right, folks, the deck is Secret Hunter. The goal of the deck is to play some combination of secrets and wild seeds in the early game to gain control of the board, apply pressure to our opponent, use Scavenger's Ingenuity to potentially hit a Tundra Rhino so that we can burst our opponent down with some of the beasts, including things like Petting Zoo, which can generate a wide board state of birds. If you're watching this on YouTube, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You can catch me live at twitch.tv/Rawful. Hey, GG Escape Artist. It was a fun game, but pretty infuriating by the end of it for me. I could not draw the Wax of Dread to save my life.
Sylvanas versus Malfurion.
I must protect the wild.
The penalty for treason is death.
It's kind of redundant. I can go 2 into this plus a secret on 3.
Ah, I see you brought guests.
Okay. Hey, welcome, AP.
My blood boils for war.
Okay, was not expecting aggro druid. Explosive trap is good into that, though. As will be the Tavish. This is a lot of damage already.
Caught this one eating party snacks.
Yep. Cards that they get here. Welcome, Lila. Free. Tree.
My blood boils for war.
What is it?
What is it?
Where you followed?
What if I just go face here?
It'll be our little secret.
Spit that out. A lot of damage already. And I've got a Tavish for next turn. The ice block is really what sealed it, though. Me a cat.
Yeah.
Why trade when we can force the opponent to trade? We just have hero power plus Tundra Rhino next turn. So there's no reason to reveal the kitty cat here. I'm gonna be honest with you, I had no idea that card existed. GG? Why would this be GG? Got a massive life total lead. Block.
You followed.
Oh hey, our Huffer has charge. Huffer has two charges? Yeah, I should give him Wind Fury for that. What is the skin?
I see you brought gas.
Only 30 health could mean it's the aggro Shadow Priest, which Explosive Trap is good into. The Renathal version. Or like the Reno version, Explosive Trap is not as great into.
Done.
the Shadow Hunter? Yeah, they even have a Hunter Yara power. Okay, wandering is good.
The shadow engulfs us.
Oh, oh my God. Well, I found all my defensive secrets at least. Getting a Millhouse off of the secret, calling it now. There is no possible way to get a Millhouse off of any of my secrets. Will be. So I think I need to go here. It'll be 7 plus 8. Wait, where am I getting 7? 7 plus 8, 15. Oh, I wanted the tanger there. That's alright. I can use the Tundra Rhino for trades now. I'm just trying to play around Void Touched Attendant as best as I can because the Crab Rider is spooky into that. Seems like they know it's explosive and are planning for around that. Still good for me. Still have a Wandering for that. Couldn't that have just gone on the crab? Two attack or more, please. Thank you. Gets revealed here, right? No, it doesn't. Play it a little safer here, just because mind blasts are concerning. And despite the fact that we do have some burst, the opponent still seems to be the aggressor here.
A cruel fate awaits you in the ashes.
Got 8, 16. 21. Yeah, we should be able to get there. 23 with the hero power. But I assume they're going to use a defensive hero power on one of my minions. Probably the 3-2. But we should still have more than enough, just because the stag with the Tundra Rhino is an obscene amount of damage. Even with the Crab Rider into the Mad Scientist, I think we should be okay. Yeah, they got a lot of those back, because they got a lot of those early. Shadow Priest have heals. No. It is, well, Reno Shadow Priest has heals, but Shadow Priest is not a deck that wants heals. It's an aggro deck. And most healing spells are holy spells. I think I coined the bunker into Secret Keeper plus one mana secret. I see you, and then followed up with the Wild Spirits. Weird. Alarming.
Caught this one eating party snacks.
God, I'm so bad at dealing with Grey Bow too. Is this helping Lemon to explode? Okay.
Thank you.
Freezing Trap kind of our best hope? I don't know. Like, it's just... I think a Stag Charge is actually my best hope. Like, I need to be able to fully clear the board. And... like, Freezing Trap is a ways away.
Were you followed?
Why did it have to be Grey Bell? There's just no world in which I win this game of Hearthstone. There's almost nothing I can do to clear this effectively. Other than maybe get my own Grey Bow. But that doesn't seem likely to happen because they want to kill the Grey Bow, not attack with it. That guarantees that they're going to have a tree man target. Salvageable. Okay, we can get there. Oh my god. Please don't have a one mana minion. This doesn't get me there, does it? I still need a buffer.
Locked and looted.
Is it gonna be a 50-50? Did I botch this? No. Yes, because of the I have to roll a 50-50 here. Oh, thank God. I could have, yeah, I could have attacked with the weapon, stag charged that, and then just attacked with the wild seed. I forgot the wild seed could attack. God, I can't hit the tinger ever. That should still be enough, right? My brain is just completely fried from the Grey Bow, I'm gonna be honest. Like, it's really hard to, to focus after that. Want to take a break? Sure, I'll just stop in the middle of this game of Hearthstone. Is that the second one of those this game?
It'll be our little secret.
What secrets do I have left? Cat. Wandering. Because I'm gonna increase the cost of my. Oh my god, not like this. They have. It's just cat in hand, right? Do they have even cost cards? Probably a lot of two mana minions still. There are lethal adds for me as well, I suppose.
That should upgrade, probably.
Especially with the vengeful visage up. It's 13 damage. if the hero power.
What have we here?
It's not necessarily lethal with a visage, because if they hero power, they go to 3 and then they can attack with a squirrel and then I die. Right? 5, 7, 9.
What have we here?
So I have to take trades here. I ran out of time to actually pick that, so I'm gonna hold. Draw Warpor. Ow. Just magically draw the. What? If you meant off of Obama, it only draws spells, so there was a 0% chance of drawing the Warpor. So yeah, they absolutely would have hero powered first, and we would have died if we relied on the visage. So, this is still GG though.
Well played.
You fight like a storm pike.
The Gray Bow turn could have been better, but again, I don't know. It's really hard to work through Gray Bow turns, and it causes, for me at least, a lot of mistakes.
Sylvanas versus Uther.
I will fight with honor.
The penalty for treason is death.
It's easy, Raffle, just generate Shard of the Naru. I mean, that makes about as much sense as some of the suggested plays you were making. We'll keep this. I don't have a 1 drop, but I have a 2, 3, 4. This deck doesn't reliably hit one drops anyway. Just straight dudes.
Caught this one eating party snacks.
Damn. I would like to find some wild seeds to or wild spirits to get that online a little quicker. Much worse are Kazaka's golems than Kazaka spells, same effects mostly? No, their effects are very different, and the Kazaka's spells are much better, which makes sense because you have a higher ask in terms of your deck building. I'm just gonna kill dudes because I'm concerned about this. Oof. Okay, I was playing around Avenge, and it was not Avenge. Just a board clear on a body.
Ugh.
good if they have like a wide board here. Excuse me? Yeah, I don't actually have any idea what we're up against here. You really look like the Raffle on Twitch. Out of curiosity, where do you think you are right now? I think it caught her. I'm just going to throw that out there. She seemed effectively caught. The victory is- I wanted to see where that was going. That looked like an interesting deck. Or autocomplete. Autocomplete does not work that way and hasn't for years.
Sylvanas versus Illidan.
The Legion's rage pales before mine.
The penalty for treason.
As much as I want to like mulligan for more secrets, I don't think I can because Wild Spirits is just too good of a card. Chat, this would be an appropriate time to predict a rogue. Not that I would be crazy enough to do so, but just saying. That's bait Raffle and I know it, not gonna risk it. I mean, look at their hero power, though. The evidence is suggesting it could be a rogue. Boom! I'm so much better at this than Twitch chat, it's unbelievable.
Thank you.
This is why I wanted to get the bedding zoo down in case they had an easy break on the explosive, which they did, but they opted not.
Job's done.
How are you doing this? What am I doing? Winning games of Hearthstone? Pre-recorded stream? Yeah, I mean, all of my streams are pre-recorded. You should know this by now. You've been here long enough. 37 month sub doesn't realize all my streams are pre-recorded. SMH my head.
Trust no one, not even me. More meat.
It's true, I'm a plant to make them seem live. Yeah, you all are. Feels like a marginally better play around Reno, which I think is the only way they get it. Oh, it can't be Reno. They have double null. Never mind. Paid actors? Yeah, I play my I pay my opponents and my viewers, so please subscribe because I'm going broke. To clarify, for all you dummies on YouTube that accuse me of such things, that's a joke. Milk, $5. Bread, $6. Paying off viewers and opponents, $15,000. Eggs, $7. Please help my family. It's going hungry. Exactly. I'll be right back. All this cues.
Sylvanas versus Lazul.
Saw this encounter.
The penalty for treason is death.
Let's draw the secrets off a bunker. Oh god, it's a big priest.
I see you brought I see you.
Oh wait. Not big priest. Seeds to work towards. No secrets though for the heading zoom. Or
where you followed.
About this one? Do they have a lash? Okay. Well, I found a way to generate some secrets. Go here, 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 hero power.
By the power of
well met.
Ice Blossom, thank you for the 9 months. Appreciate that. Alternatively, I could just get my bow here. That was a bad order because of the potential for the fox. I could have gotten 2 damage to face. Sure. I was just about to say I'm waiting for a board clear here. So that I can go in on my petting zoos. This one.
In Asharon,
I do not want to buy the old gods, thank you very much. That's gotta be a seance, yeah. Zola? Zola isn't really a concern here. They can't Reno now, though. What is going on? That just makes you dead.
Was your destiny.
I guess it was just my destiny to win. Any thoughts on the Lord of the Rings series? It looks great. Pacing is weird. Like, it just blasted through a few things at the beginning and then just came to a screeching halt. And seems to be really dead set on keeping as much information hidden as possible, which is bad when you're releasing things 1 week at a time. No spoilerino? I'm not spoiling anything. I wouldn't do that. But I don't know. I enjoy watching shows in Middle Earth, and it looks great, so I'm trying to stay optimistic. But it didn't feel as good as House of Dragon, to me at least.
I see you've brought guests.
Like, I don't mind slow, but it's the way that they're going slow. They're going slow with like trying to set up as many different mysteries as possible, and it's just like I'm starting to lose interest and focus on each of the individual mysteries because they're all over the place. Let's get a stag charge. Just to set up a big Tundra Rhino turn, potentially. For some reason, the dwarves look too thin to me. They should be bulkier. I mean, they just look a lot different than, like, the movie dwarves.
Well met.
Hey, I guess I could understand that. Hey, welcome, Shady Yama. Thank you for the 7 months. Sure is some damage coming at me. Okay.
Well met.
20 months on the 0609. That only lacks a 4.
Thank you, 8 of 8, for the 20 months. Appreciate that. I guess it's 5,000 years before the Lord of the Rings, so they could evolve. Yeah, I mean, like, the hobbits, or in this case, Harfoots, look different, too, so... Humans 5,000 years ago probably look different too. I don't actually want to develop any minions here to force the attacks into my face and proc the explosive trap. Hey, welcome, Ronnie. I thought episodes 1 and 2 of House of Dragon were good, but episode 3 was quite a bit worse. Episode 2 was a little bit slow for my taste. Episode 3 was kind of meandering until the end. Oh, wow. But, like, the pilot was very, very good and gave me a lot of hope for the series.
So.
God. There's just no slowing down this deck, is there? Maybe another stag charge? That can help. And just making a, like, intimidating board state is really what we need. I assume we'll see a ton more time jumps in House of Dragons? Yeah. I mean, that's... I don't mind that, but, like... I don't know. I feel like the lead actress is doing a very good job in the role, and I don't want to lose that. So I'm kind of disappointed that she's going to be gone soon. Because they've already announced the time jumps. And replacing the actresses. So I don't mind that. Personally, I'm just kind of sad that she's going to be gone soon. Tried making a deck with Cthulhu the Shattered with Baku, but Baku doesn't always trigger. Do you know why? Well, Baku should never trigger. Because Cthulhu starts as an even card. and start of game effects check your starting deck. It does 50% of the time. I think that must be a bug, because that's not at all how it should be. Start of game effects happen randomly. If you have two, they might work. Yeah, but it's completely irrelevant, because start of game effects should always check the deck that you enter the game with, not the deck that is currently there. Or rather, not the deck that is showing on screen. Or at least that's how it's been explained to me. Just set up some taunts and make an aggressive board. Yeah, I think it's just a bug. Because, like, it would never work that way with Benedictus, right? With Benedictus, one always supersedes the other, if I'm not mistaken. So... I don't know. It should be looking, regardless of what is happening, it should be looking at the start of game effect. That's why, like, I've played Odd Paladin with Prince Malcazar, and I used to do it all the time, and Baku always worked, because, again, it checks your start of game thing. I think it's something specific with, obviously, C'Thun, because, I don't know, maybe C'Thun is breaking apart too early or something. I need early game and probably the Wild Seeds against Shaman. Well, it's sort of early game and sort of Wild Seeds.
I see you've brought
guests. We have turned our curse into our strength.
I wonder if C'Thun also breaks Gen decks. Based on that, probably, but again, that doesn't mean that's how the behavior should happen. Oof.
Job's done.
Rush? Nice. Okay. That can help me deal with an anchored totem next turn. Oof. That is a bad, bad turn for the opponent.
Come, Midnight.
Still think I want to go here. Next turn I have a decision to make. Probably want to lean towards the Kazamicus.
I am the harvester of wrath. Would you like to learn why?
Copy. Also pretty good. Join late? How frustrated are you? What a weird way to enter a stream. I suppose I am now more frustrated than before you got here.
Predictable.
I just want to know how much longer you'll be on for. I mean, then there are much better ways you could have. Still, same applies.
Where you followed?
Decide which 5-drop I want here. Probably has to be the golem now. That golem worked out, yeah. But I'm still not doing great here. Because the Aerolorn is still quite slow.
This curse has become
so is Glenn, though. But they're probably going to trade the Glenn into the Aerolorn, so.
No creature deserves to be caged.
Let's just try and push through the board. A wild spirits. Oh my god. Okay, I can kill that at least. Usually, unless they get a taunt totem off of the weapon. Oh wait. This doesn't have stealth? Why did I think this had stealth? Oh my god, what? Okay, they really want to protect that. I guess this is why. Do they have the copy? Oh my god. What are you doing? Okay. Why would you double up? That's... sure. Whatever. I mean, I'm still gonna lose to this, but... for the rhino. I'm just dead here, right? Unless they do something outrageously bad, which, you know, last turn. Do it. Attack with the... Oh, they are so close. Taunt?
Let me light the way.
Oh my god. Absolutely unreal. Not too happy about a priest, but we do have a fair amount of burst.
Is death.
It's almost certainly Big Priest. Especially with them roping me on turn one. That's good when I've got a Tundra Rhino in hand and get 8/8 charging. I have 10 burst. Okay. That changes everything.
Is someone injured?
Probably just need to coin a Tavish.
Come, Midnight.
Fools! My head!
For now.
Uh-oh. God.
Such easy
sport. Crab could still present some problems. Because they can just rush in with the crab. Play this game. They risk the freeze last turn, but not this turn. Stream sniping? No, freeze is not a commonly run main deck secret, but it is very easy to get off of Tavish, so it makes complete sense. At least in my opinion. I don't think there's any reason to believe the opponent is sniping. We are well protected here, so it'd be GG.
Your purpose awaits.
Man, they're looking kind of dead here. That's a card, yeah. I mean, appears effective here, but. Isn't quite going to be enough. Bonk!
Ah!
Deck's actually doing pretty good. 8 and 9. Go one more. Those priests thing I thought still a ton though. I was queuing into a lot of priests earlier with the paladin deck that had no chance against them. And then yesterday with the villager rogue that had 100% win rate against them.
Let the hunt begin.
The penalty for treason is death.
Let's keep a Lothab in case. I don't know. It's a quest line. It was like silly thing to anticipate.
I see you've brought guests.
Are there ever any decks that you play that don't make it to your YouTube channel? Occasionally, but not terribly often. Beaver. Okay, they're gonna have to kill that themselves. Or kill one of their own minions themselves. They could with like a wound prey, but I don't know that that would be worth it. Goodbye, board. Good draw. Oh my god, what a horrible 1 in 3 that was. Guess we're not playing a card here. That was really frustrating. But it seems to be playing the mainstream version of this deck with Hydralodon. I mean, it's just a completely different archetype. That's Beast Hunter, this is Secret Hunter. I can't let them draw more. And this doesn't telegraph the explosive quite as hard. Wild Seeds make them feel similar because they have some of the best cards. I mean, we have like maybe 8 of the same cards. Like the only overlap is the Wild Seeds and Thunder Rhino.
Well met.
Windchill Factor
is low key broken.
No, it seems to be working fine. Also, like, I'm losing this game, so I don't know if this is good evidence for Bunker being a broken card. But thank you for the 33 months. This Lotheb is looking really silly in my hand right now, though. Good God. Get off a Tavish that would help me here.
You better watch your step and that spell.
Like, this doesn't help me at all. Clears one minion off of this board. Like, the only reason I played this was so that I didn't die to a Thunder Rhino, which is feeling kind of inevitable. Just seals it. Oh my god. That's just horrendously, devastatingly bad, and I have no outs anymore. I needed to be able to play the, the petting zoo here, I think.
Come, midnight.
Oh, GG. I think the weapon stag is still strong after nerf, or is it serves a purpose as is? Yeah. I mean, you still run wild seeds in nearly every hunter archetype that you can imagine, so. I'm dead to a rhino.
Quickly.
Why did that take so long to figure out? Are you kidding me? Oh my god. Just kill me. Just kill me. Alright, I'll go one more. You did not need to waste my time there. Unfortunately, even Shaman is a very strong deck.
The penalty for treason is death.
But we got the Wild Spirits at least. It's probably our best bet into even Shaman. It's not even Shaman.
It'll be our little secret.
Twins. That denies the Phlegletox now, doesn't it?
Just between us.
So I'm fine with that.
Nature waits for no one but me.
In Asharon's name.
Oh my god, how does that every single time it's a 1 in 3 I hit the stupid rhino. It's getting ridiculous. Should be able to get there next turn. Blue thing is, I think that is the most helpful you have ever been. I'm proud of you. I can't leave this no ball up. Luke Nukem, thank you for the 4 months.
Wounded to leave the inevitable.
I feel like that was true of you, Ragnaros, with that snowball guardian.